So let's see the differences among these three technologies. And these three technologies are Hive, LLAP, and then third one is Impala. Now LLAP stands for long live and process. So I'm just writing down the definition: long live and process. So Hive was developed at Facebook, and Hive LLAP was developed Hortonworks to make Hive faster. Basically, the Hive actually is a batch and it is slow. So Hive LLAP is basically an attempt to run Hive queries faster, and it is part of Hive 2.0 only. It's part of this release. So it's not something which is different from Hive. It is part of another release from Hortonworks, which is Hive 2.0. Impala is from Cloudera, and it is also for interactive querying. So that's another project, pet project of Cloudera, based on Google Dremel white paper. So Hive was released around year 2007. This was released around 2015. And this was released around 2012. So it is end of 2012, startup conference, this was announced. Hive, you will find use cases like sentiment analysis, log file analysis. So these kind of use cases are common when you have basically long running jobs. So then you will be going for this kind of thing, like you want to perform long running ETL. So maybe latency is minutes to hours. So that is latency. Your job latency is minutes to hours. So it takes time because it is long running job. Now Hive LLAP is for ad hoc analysis, and you will be using these for short-lived query. So when you have short-lived queries, then we'll be using it. So same thing like here also, interactive queries, short-lived queries, ad hoc queries. So interactive ad hoc queries, you will be using Impala. Similarly, interactive. And here again short-lived. So when I say short-lived, that means you can say it is, the latency is seconds to minutes latency. Okay, so next one is like the Hive framework is based on MapReduce. It can run on MapReduce, it can run on Spark, it can run on Theia. So a lot of data processing technologies can be there under Hive, but Hive LLAP is for Theia only. Like it was developed at Hortonworks, and Theia is one of the favorite projects of Hortonworks. Now Hortonworks is not there, but the project Hive LLAP can run on Theia only. And this project Impala is MPP, massively parallel processing. This is the architecture, massively parallel processing architecture. If you see, like this is fault tolerant. Yeah, so this is also fault tolerant because it is also Hive, but Impala is not fault tolerant. So this is very important difference, not fault tolerant. So you will be using in those use cases when user presence is there. So if a particular query framework is fault tolerant, then that means you can actually fire and forget. It is batch. So you can just reschedule it during nightly batch, and tomorrow you can see the results. But here, when something is not fault tolerant, then user presence is required, and you are actually looking at the results. If something fails, query fails, then you have to retry manually. So you have to rerun the query again. So that's the problem with Impala. But in Hive, we can just schedule it through Airflow or Uzi and then let it run and take time. So once the query is failed in between, like there are any issues, then there will be retry of tasks, because there are mapper tasks, taste tasks. So these tasks, yarn containers, will be recreated automatically by the framework. We don't have to worry, but in Impala we have to basically think about it. So apart from that, Hive is Java based, and this Hive LLAP is also Java based, but Impala is C++, more closer to bare metal system programming language. Java is application programming language. JVMs are created. There are issues related to garbage collection, but here we don't have those things. So definitely it will give you better performance with that regard. Just see Hive limitation. Hive limitation is it is very slow, slowest option. Hive LLAP limitation is it is restricted to phase only framework. And Impala limitation is it is having no fault tolerance. So these are limitations of these technologies. So in Hive LLAP, updates are allowed on ORC file asset, on ORC file. But if you see like in Impala, no data update functionality, no data update functionality available. So hope this gives you an idea which technology to choose when. So you will be going for Impala when you are working in an ecosystem which is basically having Impala daemons installed, and if you are coming from that background, so a lot of companies are coming from Cloudera background, they are using Impala. But the main thing is interactive use case, short-lived query where you don't care about fault tolerance. But if you care about fault tolerance, then you have to choose one of these two options. But the problem with Hive is it is phase only. Hive LLAP is phase only, but Hive is for long running jobs. And then we have Spark SQL also, so you can run Hive on Spark SQL, so you will get the benefits of Catalyst Optimizer and the components that Spark provides. So it depends, like if you're going for long running thing or you are going for like short lived query, depending on that, you will choose one of these frameworks.